Dear learners, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Saurabh Dikshit from Indian Institute of Tourism and Travel Management, an autonomous organization of Ministry of Tourism, Government of India, Gwalior. Today we shall be taking module number 7. Its title is Principles of Tour Guiding under the paper Tour Guiding Essentials. Dear learners, after studying this module, you shall be in position to understand principles of tour guiding, importance of tour guiding, meaning of principles. Let us start with introduction. Tour guiding is a field job a tour guide has to liaison with tourist or client, with people from many areas and from all walks of life. He must have certain principles. It helps him sustain for a long time period. The significance of a tour guide is realized by people have real intention to visit, see and understand the value of the tourist place. A good tour guide makes your tour well planned and he helps you to save time and resources. The country is full of tourism destinations. Each one offers unique attraction as far as heritage, history, nature and climate is concerned. India is the only country where you will find the vast change in the weather, languages, dialects, flora and fauna, etc. Tour guide has to accompany the tourist all the times. He makes your journey fruitful by adding charm and happiness. If you have second thought about the services of tour guide, do not compare his service with the price you pay for through guiding. Guide converts your tour package cost into an asset by transfer of good information. Now let us talk about second subtopic of this module, that is principles of tour guiding. A good tour guide ensures qualitative services to the tourist. Tour guides work on certain ethos, professional code of conduct and principles. They are given license after proper training conducted by the appropriate authority. So they are reliable and trustworthy. Majority these principles are to act professionally with the client, stakeholders as far as tourism related services are concerned. To charge reasonably if charging directly, otherwise these charges are fixed up by the government and are part of tour package costing. To create good image of himself, that is tour guide, local people, region or state and country for which he is working. To protect the environment, ecology, flora and fauna, animals, birds and species, water bodies, small creatures, etc. To protect sensitivities of locals, their traditions, rituals and project in positive manner. To offer professional services to the tourist. To fulfill commitment of the travel agency. A tour guide has to ensure that facts and figures are presented properly and in appropriate manner. A tour guide is the cultural brand ambassador of the country and he can promote the country. He should be positive and proactive in his professional working. He should not allow and encourage tourists to criticize the country on any issue. A tour guide must abide by law and have workable information of law. A tour guide should not indulge into debate, arguments, quarrel with the tourist. He must keep himself away from any controversy. Do not be overcommitted. Being a tour guide, you are the icon of India in front of tourists. So you must portray Indianness in your behavior and nature. Tour guide must be empathetic and caring towards tourists. Being a tour guide, you should keep your transactions clear and beyond any doubt. Be flexible. Being a tour guide, you must be flexible as far as time schedule is concerned. Consider request of clients or tourists. Your ultimate aim should be to make your clients or tourists happy and blissful. As you know, in tourism industry, our product is experience. Without good experience, your job is unfinished. Be professional. Being a tour guide, you must understand the meaning of professionalism. The professional is any kind of paid occupation. Professional is a person involved in a profession. He is paid for that job. So he is liable for best in trade services. He gives maximum output by using optimum resources. You must keep yourself cool and calm in all kind of situations. As you have to satisfy the tourist, be friendly in nature and behavior. Try to create right image of the country and your region in which you are living. Suppose you are guiding in North India region, explain them about the place and tell them that its rich history and culture. But before communicating, get it confirmed from reliable sources. If you are referring internet sources, find out the validity of the source of information. See websites of Government of India, Archaeological Survey of India, reputed library sources or of various universities, and the website of National Museum, Ministry of Culture, the Ministry of Tourism, etc. You must understand that every word you speak, your behavior, your gesture towards the tourist, your comments about the region, the country have an impact on tourists. They observe very minutely and create an image of country accordingly. Be proactive. A tour guide must be proactive in nature. Proactive means he should work in advance and do not wait for happening of any problem. A tour guide must sense future requirements and keep himself to meet every kind of emergency. This skill is mostly useful in all kind of tours, but required more in adventure. Once we were going to Manali, Solang Dhundi track, our guides felt that weather conditions are not favorable and he stopped us on the way at safe place. Call your client on one day advance and confirm his program. Reconfirmation help to minimize communication gap and enhance service production. You should know what is happening around you. You must comprehend that you are their well-wisher and it will help them to understand the place. Temperament. Nowadays, our lifestyle is quite hectic. We are becoming multitasker. We have to manage a number of jobs at one time, like practical guiding, receiving telephone calls of travel agents, liaising with monument people. Many times a tour guide lose temper and clients are victim of short-tempered tour guide. It must be avoided in any situation. There is no excuse if you are losing your temper. Being a tour guide, we must listen our clients carefully and respond them politely. Experience in the tourism industry, our product is an experience. In title, it's written there three times to convey its strength or intensity. We must believe that there is only one thing for which tourist has crossed thousands of miles from his home place. That is experienced in the core of heart. A guide is a medium to ensure a good experience. Travel should be unique experience for tourist under the guidance of experienced tour guide. Do not overcommit. Whatever services you are providing must be as per your commitment before the starting of tour. In any case, do not overcommit. Overcommitment spoils image of any professional. Make them happy. You must have principle to make them happy, blissful, under any circumstances. They have come out of their workplace in the expectation to get happiness. Do not encourage them in your day-to-day problems. Be fully informed. The present age is the age of internet, social media. Everyone is information overloaded. Tourists explore Google before traveling, so they are aware of common information. So, fully informed and have some extra information, knowledge, guide them with wisdom. Be responsive. The tour guide must be a responsible person. He must advise clients time to time and realize tourists that he is working responsibly, not only in talk but in action also. Reliability. Your or tour guide's behavior and commitments must be reliable. Your reliability will create a sense of trust among clients or tourists. A reliable tour guide sustains for a longer time. Be a man with knowledge. Knowledge gives a sense of confidence in a commentary maker. A knowledgeable person can give answer of all queries raised by the tourist. So nurture habit of reading regularly from good and reliable sources. Create information base. Knowledge is essence of information. The success of tour depends on knowledge imparted by a good tour guide. A tour guide must be passionate about tour. He must also be well aware of each and every detail of the tour. Knowledge helps in raising satisfaction level of clients. Value for money. Always keep in mind that you are providing value for money. Tourists or clients have paid for the deluxe tour. He must be served in the way to feel that he is given privileges. But in one group, do not differentiate clients. If you are treating two clients differently, they will not carry good image or impression, and your purpose of making everyone happy will be defeated. If you will work as per your principles to treat everyone equal, it will help you to sustain for longer time without any major complaint. You must have a principle about tips also. Do not act against the system or practices of your company, system or country. Grooming. In principle, our dress must suit the occasion, profession, weather conditions and traditions. I feel that a tour guide must be in proper attire in which he must feel comfortable. Keep away from trendy dresses, distracts clients. Do not try to look smarter than tourists. Do not compare yourself. A good dressing sense gives a lot of confidence in working. I feel that Indian dresses are also creating positive impressions and good image in the mind of tourists. Indian dresses are designed keeping in mind climate and comfort. Tourists also accept people wearing dresses as per their culture. After dressing, we must know how to groom. If we are groomed properly, we will be able to impress the tourists or our clients. Have complete information. Have principle to be transparent and believe in full disclosure. Your tour guiding profile must be updated, precise and accurate. Sudden changes in the tour are possible due to change in weather, climatic conditions, nature, etc. Be keen to know details about hazards, safety and security of tourists. Now let's come to the next subtopic, that is why a tour guide must have principles. Our daily action decide habits. A tour guide must have to follow a certain set of statements about his profession. These statements must be framed in line with nature. These statements are known as principles. Principles decide success or failure of our profession. If a tour guide abides by the principles, he will be able to sustain for longer time. His job, will be easier. Next subtopic is major roles of a tour guide. A tour guide is a professional who serves tourists for commentary making, normal assisting, providing relevant information, etc. A tour guide in the guides in the language of tourists. His basic job is to know the place, tourist attractions, and deliver the same to the client or tourist in his language according to his intellectual level. He must be able to understand the intellectual level of tourist and must interpret commentary accordingly. A tour guide plays multifaceted roles. He is an information provider to impart information about timings, places, altitude, bus, train or air system, society, political system, people, places, geography, history, flora and fauna, heritage, etc. He is a counselor. Tour guide is a counselor. He counsels his clients on many issues. He is an assistant. Assist in transfers from airport to hotel and hotel to airport. He is an entertainer. He entertains tourists while free time. Many tourists visiting from Russia remember songs of Raj Kapoor ji. So he can sing songs and take them to the golden past of Indian cinema. A tour guide is a caretaker. He takes care of tourists, his belongings. He is an advisor, advises about pickpocketers, thieves, chain snatchers, thugs, duplicate products in shopping, etc. He is an expert in adventure. Guide has expertise in activities like trekking, parasailing, scuba diving, snorkeling, jungle safari, etc. During crisis, he is a cook. He can cook if required in crisis during trekking expeditions with the help of locals. He is a leader. Who is a leader? It is a billion-dollar question. One of my non-professors is a head of the National Level Institute. He makes his team find a chance in media and get appreciation. He keeps his team first. A good tour guide must make his clients smile after every successful ride of paragliding. He must appreciate tourists' stamina, interest, inclination towards India. He must identify their positive points and bring them forward. Now, let us come to the job. A tour guide has to lead a group in ruined cities, heritage sites, wildlife sanctuaries, forests, mountains, valleys. He has to keep them under one aim, that is to make the tour successful. Many members get away due to their personal reasons, but a good guide keeps them engaged by his leadership skills. Commentary maker. What is commentary? When I was little child, my grandmother used to tell me stories. I had to say yeah after every sentence. That is the mark of acknowledgement to grandmother that I am listening and you proceed ahead. I was tempted till end of the story. She was the best storyteller in my life. Do you remember the story of Loin sung by legendary icon Shri Amitabh Bachchan ji in the movie Mr. Natwarlal? Mere paas aao mere doston, ek kissa sunao. A storyteller has the power of magnet to attract people and keep them waiting until the end of story. My friend tells a story of Taj Mahal and explains Mumtaz and King. I saw people literally weeping by the end of the story. It is the power of commentary making by a good tour guide. It cannot be replaced by any audio system. The commentary makes a long-lasting memory or impression of a tour guide in the mind of a tourist. I found that tour guides are popular due to their commentary making or oratorship among the tour groups. People remember stories for longer time, but they cannot recall years, complex messages. I think a tour guide must work hard and practice for a long time by making this his own videos, and collecting feedback from friends. Commentary makes a tour guide perfect, but commentary should be supported by good knowledge base. Assistant to traveler to understand region and lifestyle. Many tour guides provide them tourists walking to villages to understand lifestyle and culture. They assist them in this exercise and help them to talk to villagers, artisans, handicraft makers. I found that people living in Odisha offer daily prayer in temples. It is a good practice. We can show it to the tourists so that they could understand the way of performing prayer. It is a matter of practically feeling. You cannot understand just by seeing the picture of it. Counselor, in many situations, tourists feel nervous because they are away from their place. Your guides must also act as counselors and counsel his clients or tourists. Information provider, when I was on travel to Malaysia, our tour guide took us to coach after welcoming at the airport and shifting luggage in the coach. It was our first interaction with the coach. It started with welcome message. First, responsibility of a tour guide and of course guiding principle to welcome. Then he mentioned that he will speak in Hindi as his forefathers were migrated to Malaysia from pre-independent India. Then he explained about Malaysia, its currency, states, political system, mobile phone companies and their charges, roads, economy, etc. His talk till refreshment on the way kept us engaged and it was very informative. Walking encyclopedia, a tour guide must walk the talk. His good knowledge helps the tourist to virtually visualize the past. It is difficult to understand history without a tour guide. You cannot imagine the place without tour guide. For example, when I went to Pithoragarh in Uttarakhand, our tour guide Sahab told us about fruits like berries, kafal, buras, mountains, the problem of a landslide. Otherwise, I could not collect so much information. Awareness above all, practical tricks to sense weather. Without our tour guide, it means a tour guide must have knowledge of every part of life in the place where he is guiding. Next subtopic is tour guide job responsibilities. I have a role of teacher while working in the college inside the classroom. My responsibilities are to take attendance, to teach, to give work assignments to my students, to take their feedback. I think now you must be clear about role and responsibilities. In previous sections, we discussed roles of tour guides. His responsibilities are to take tourists comfortable to the destination, safety and security, timings, instruction before and after the tour, about places, do's and do nots, weather conditions, local sentiments, a legal system, etc. Next subtopic is duties of a tour guide. Duties of tour guide are varied. It also depends on the country in which he is working. Like many countries allow coach drivers to do guiding also. He can tell the group about place coming on the way as well as drive the coach at the same time. I have not seen such practice in our country, India. A tour guide must have many duties, starting with the pre-holiday planning. He will be required to prepare a list of all the major tourist places in that region. Then he will have to make all the arrangements in advance to make the visit possible. Handling the tourist transportation like coaches, buses, taxi, etc. and accommodation, for example, hotels, motels, resort, etc. of the tourist will also be his responsibility. Next subtopic is personal requirements. A tour guide must have few qualities. He must have patience while an undergoing tour. He must be proactive and take important responsibilities and expedite with full dedication. He must know multiple languages, for example, the language of tourist, local language, and must be able to translate from one language to the other. Next subtopic is working conditions. A tour guide must have good health and be able to work in varied climatic conditions. While doing the tour, he has to face many changes in the climate and sudden changes in the weather. He must have the knowledge to forecast weather using conventional means, as GPS will not work in few mountain areas. Now let us summarize this module. The principle means certain norms decided by the person that he would follow in his profession. Principles change the image of a tour guide. If all guides are working on certain principles, destination will excel and it will create a positive image of the destination. Roles are basically positions assigned to the team members. Responsibilities are specific jobs someone has to expedite as a part of his role. Tour guide is a person who liaises with the tourist. He has various roles and responsibilities. Thank you.